Welcome to RainDeck software video tutorial number 4, how to add products through purchase entry. In order to that, you can see over here the purchase entry button in the home screen itself. Here you just click on that, you can see the purchase entry form. Here you will see in the first portion, here you can see over here the supplier informations, from which supplier you are taking the materials. You can add a supplier with this green button over here. Just type this supplier name, for example ABC supplier, ABC, and the address you can mention, the supplier address, and the supplier city also you can mention here. And the supplier state, maybe the other state, maybe your own state, that also you can mention over here. For example, I am mentioning here Kerala. And this contact number is must. I just put 123456 to understanding. You can put your supplier details over here. And very important thing is that, see, the supplier email ID, supplier GST number, everything you can mention over there. The space is already there, you can use it. And one another important information I want to give you, here you can see the opening balance, credit or debit. This is why we are giving this facility. This is one time process only you can do, you cannot edit it. Because it is security reasons we have fixed it in one time. For example, when you are adding this supplier, if for this particular supplier, in the previous balance dues or something, we need to pay them back. That you can mention over there. For example, 1 lakh rupees, you need to pay them back. The previous outstanding is there. You can mention over there and you can save it so that it will already come in accounts, ledger. I just put it in zero and I save it. I save it properly. That's it. So the company information, the supplier information already came over here. The next step, you can purchase the products in debit or cash. Here the informations are there. This is the one. Here you can see cash purchase or credit purchase. And invoice number you can mention over here. The supplier, invoice number and invoice date you can mention over here. Here also you can, invoice date you can mention over here. And here if you are coming in the portion, this portion is very important portion in this purchase entry. You can do the purchase like that, select the, we add last video, we add products through Excel sheet. If you can click on that and you can change the quantity, for example 100 piece or add it, you can add it like that. If the product is we did not added before through Excel sheet, or we did not added through inventory system, you can directly add it. Just type, for example, calculator. Example, before we did not added calculator, just typing here C, I just typing here calculator, C A L C U L C A L C U L A T O R, I think spelling is correct. Calculator. And just click on enter button in the keyboard, then it will ask it is a new product. Yes, it is a new product. Then automatically here this zero will visible over here, here also zero. That means the system is already generating one barcode in by its own, company barcode means the system generated barcode is coming over here. You can put your part number, you can put your color black, you can put your size, or you can put your other information like how many pieces. You can see over here, 155 pieces, retail price 100 rupees, and discount is there, retail discount. For example, 100 rupees is MRP and 10 rupees you need to put a discount, so means 90 rupees it will be sale price. And purchase you can put it over here, some, for example 50 rupees is your purchase rate. Okay, so in the purchase discount also you can mention over here. And GST, if there, for example 9%, 18% GST example, so 9 you can mention to CGST and SGST over here. See, CGST is 9, SGST is 9, simple. And if you are putting wholesale also, you can, for example, retail you mentioned on 100 rupees, wholesale maybe 90 rupees or 80 rupees wholesale price. Wholesale, if you have, you want to provide any discount amount, for example, 2 rupees, you need to put discount because wholesale is huge. And even 1 rupees also, it will run 2 lakhs. And just you can add it. So it's directly added. Even the product is not even there, not there in the list of, you can add it directly from Raindeck POS billing software purchase entry. You need to just click on save button over here. You can save like that. You can add thousands of products over there. One by one, you can add it. You just save it like that. Okay. So those product also will come there in the sale panel. I will show you. Go to the sale panel. Just select on calculator. See the calculator. You put the price over here. Sale price is 100. But here came total amount is 106. That's the reason. The tax is additional. Yani, you can put two options for the tax. That I will show you in the next video, how to manage inclusive tax, exclusive tax system. So we will go back to again purchase entry. Purchase entry, there is some other facilities we have given. You can update the purchase entry. Because a lot of our customers have thousands of products or 500 products purchased at a time. So just go to get data over here. Here you can see the button over here, get data, click on that, select on this one, you will see the purchase. For example, you need to add some other products also over here. For example, reset, select other products, sugar, add it, and for example, you can change the quantity over here. Some, for example, 110 pieces, add it, and another products also, for example, pen drive, add it. You can add your quantity and click on update over here. You can see the update button over here, this one. Click on update button, reset and update, and here click on update. Successful. Directly you can update it. No need to update it down. You can directly update it in the top. We have bypassed the system actually. So you go to that update is already saved. You can go to get data again, select that one again. You can see the purchase entry is already updated. Yani, the remaining products you have purchased last time, that also update. Again, you are seeing some other product we need to purchase. Select like that, Amla, example, Amla. It's not there in the list, Amla, okay? So Amla, I added, update. Successfully update. So once you click the update button, maybe you need to wait 1 or 2 seconds to fix it. Then it will be automatically updated. No need to click continuously in the update button. Again, you go to get data, see that purchase. You can see that purchase already, Amla also is added in the purchase. Those all stock, what you are doing, what purchase you are doing in the purchase entry, all stock will be updated in the stock report also. This is the way, very simple scenario you can do your purchase entry through Excel, through purchase entry. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you, bye-bye.